those reviews. Oh, that sounds a bit fizzy. Oh, by the way, how about telling you what I'm doing here? This one is kind of a, it's a 7% McMullen. I like the label, except for it's just a little bit too much gold and not enough black. But it's kind of McMullen Strong Heart. Are we going to focus? Here we go, Strong Heart. When we eventually get a focus, without me, there we go. 7%. Show you the label, go round. Do 7%. And go round the other side. Let's have a sniff at the neck of the bottle, this one. See, it's a strange thing with beers. Sometimes you get a really good sniff off the neck of the bottle, and sometimes you smell nothing until you get it in the glass. If anyone knows what this little bit here, is it just, you know, a little shoulder there? I know there's this here that helps to hold back the sediment if you've got any, if you care about it. But there's that bit there. Is that just for show? That it's like that? Is it kind of to do with the old days when it used to be, when you used to put it on the thing and spin the, when you, you know, bottle makers and that, glass blowing and everything? What is it? Why has it got a little bubble there? There you go. If I go to show you it, I always mess it up. Wow, that is so ruby, it's unbelievable. Let's see if I can get that. Am I gonna get it? Oh, that's terrible if you don't get that. If you don't get that, that's that. No, you ain't gonna get that. How am I gonna show you that? One of my little ones mirror will do it. I've just pulled a thing to bits trying to get you a mirror to go through. Wait a minute, so are we gonna get anything going on? Oh, hold on. Yeah, there you go. In that pretty nice ruby colour there. It's beautiful, isn't it? Little mirror. Oh dear, she loves that. Makes the mirror up more than the face, you know. Thank God. With sandwiches usually and stuff like that. Get on with it. No wonder the bar flies around here. That is absolutely beautiful. Let's see if we can get the carbonation. It's not too bad. It's quite kind of active, but it's not bad. So remember, I'm tipping the glass right back, so it's coming up the side of the glass. Let's go for it. Oh, that's gonna be action, that is, I'm telling you. That's gonna be woohoo. That's got all sorts going on straight on the nose. It's got it's almost rum like on the nose. You kinda get a smell like that off of the Innocent Gun rum cask one. It's a bit like that on the nose. You're getting kind of like proper Christmas gear going on. Christmas pudding, mince pies, even down to the sugar sprinkled on it. It smells quite hefty of alcohol, even though I've had higher ones like the Golden Pride, Fuller's Golden Pride 8.5, and it's just mellowed out. And the Nigerian Guinness, I think he's 7.5, is it? Something like that. And that's just settled. But then again, I've had ones that are less than that, and they're like, ah! I think I'm going to have one more smell. Yeah, you're getting all sorts of them lovely dark notes. You're getting all sorts of plums and prunes and kind of Oh man, cherries and black currants, all sorts, but like kind of wilted ones, you know, when they've been like dried up, dried fruits, lots of currants and that mainly though, and sultanas and all that. Right, we're going in. That is a proper lush beer. That is lush. A lush beer for lushies. Wow. That is so lovely. Oh. You get that alcohol sitting in there and burning on the way down. Burning all the way down the esophagus, all the way down, even kind of the sides of your face a little bit, it seems, as you warm up and get happy, get all big rosy cheeks and that, you know, and it just warms in all the way down in your stomach. This is what you call a winter warmer. What was the idea the other day? The shepherd named something and it said was something about winter warmer or something, and it was nothing like a winter warmer. It was, you know, it was all right, it was some average beer and that, you know. But it wasn't high in alcohol, it wasn't high in these sweet and malty sort of flavours in there. How it described itself as a winter warmer, I don't know, you know. And with all the lush winter sort of fireplace and everything. But there you go, you know, they do well on some of their beers to a shepherd name. They really do. And I love them because they are a quintessentially English brewery. They've got that kind of English note about them, and that English kind of, there was English hops and stuff. Cool, you're getting something sweet in there as well, something sweet and kind of floral. That's weird. There's something very weird. Oh, I can't put my bloody foot on it. Go on, liven up. Oh, I don't think I'm going to get there. Don't know what that is. It's kind of cloves and all those lovely Christmas puddingy notes, but there's something in here. It's gonna drive me mad. It's like a tune in your head. If you're tasting this one along with me, if you're having a drink of that at home and kind of doing what I do and drinking it along as just kind of tapping away at the keyboard, yeah, tell no, you want to do this, this was definitely that flavour and all that. See if you can place that. I've got a bloody barfly. Every time I pour a beer, one turns up. I should spray the bloody fly spray before I even start. Right. I'm going to pour a bit more in before I finish this off quickly. Just pour the rest in. Might get something off the yeast and stuff. Right, whack it in. I ain't getting nothing through that froth now. It's like something Coca-Cola-y. Yes. It reminds me of sarsaparilla from way, way back. There's a sarsaparilla note there. If anyone, you've probably just tried it in the cordial, and it's a little bit like it. They've got like notes of sarsaparilla, but way back there was a drink called sarsaparilla, and you used to get it hot in off of the stalls and that, like a tea stall, you know. And you got it hot off of a tea stall, in the little cups and that, which I think was paper in them days, or like a papery cardboardy sort of stuff, and that was absolutely delicious. Or if you were standing there drinking it, they'd give you it in a cup, you know, cup and saucer, and it was a hot drink that was a kind of like a almost like a hot Coca-Cola, but very different, you know. And I think sarsaparilla is like a root of some sort, but it was delicious. It's kind of like those sort of clovey sort of flavors in it, isn't it? Well, that is sarsaparilla. Well, it's got it in it anyway. Yeah, that's that note. At last, thank God. Right. You've been lovely for putting up with me for, 14 minutes? anyway. Chin chin. Thank you for watching. Always thank you for watching. And thank you for commenting. Because I do get some lovely comments. And from the bottom of my heart, I thank you for that. Because... you know, it's lovely, it's a two-way thing then. Me and you are sitting there having a drink together then, you know, and I really enjoy that, you know. I really enjoy watching, especially if you're doing it in real time and you're sitting typing and I'm going, right, waiting for the next one, and he smelt that, and you're kind of drinking at the same pace. I play the video along with you and then you go, right, I've just smelt it, it's this, you know, that sort of thing. It's lovely. Right. Cheers, chin chin. 15 odd minutes. I'll cut this down probably, I don't know. Bye!